Somalia is in the Horn of Africa and borders Ethiopia, Kenya, and Djibouti. The country consists mostly of plateau regions and hills in the northernmost parts of the country. Somalia inhabits approximately 14.32 million people. The predominant religion is Muslim. According to the World Health Organization, Somalia's gross domestic product is $6.2 billion, none of which is spent on healthcare. 73% of Somalians are living below the poverty line. Historically, Somalia has been divided in a clan-based system. In 1969, Mohamed Siad Barre assumed power after the previous president's assassination. Barre declared Somalia as a socialist state and nationalized most of the country. From 1969 to 1991, Siad Barre ruled in Somalia. Political parties were banned, and there was no more democracy. In 1991, Siad Barre's dictatorship was overthrown, which led to a civil war amongst the Somali people. But this led to power struggles between the clan warlords, killing and wounding thousands of civilians. Since that time, Somalia has had a transitional functioning government. As a consequence, they have no public health care and no government-funded services, and minimal security of the people.
The jihadist group Al-Shabaab dominates most of rural Somalia. The terrorist group, whose allegiance lies with Al-Qaeda, was forced out of most cities and towns by the African Union troops. With an ongoing war in the country and the Al-Shabaab militants initiating frequent attacks, an estimation of 1 million people have been displaced due to threat of violence. Only 13% of the land is suitable for growing crops, but due to the current drought in West Africa, the population is plagued by food insecurity. There have been four consecutive dry years, and this is the worst drought West Africa has experienced in 40 years, and is affecting 3.3 million Somalians. Not only is the drought affecting the agriculture, the livestock is dying off as well. Unpredictable rainfall, lack of rivers and fresh water sources, and a shortage of water maintenance systems has resulted in 55% of the population not having access to safe water. As a result, the population is malnourished and at high risk for contracting a multitude of diseases.
The vulnerable populations model speaks to the ethnic perspective of the Somalian people. The first aspect is availability of resources. Somalia has a limited number of resources available due to lack of public health care. In the past few years, over 1 million people have been displaced from their homes, which has led to lack of resources in urban centers. This has contributed to decreased sanitation and hygiene, lack of potable water, and decreased livestock.
The second aspect of the model addresses the exposure to risk factors. The current drought in Somalia causes political instability and armed conflict, forces eviction, and creates food insecurity. Health services are only available through private health or humanitarian efforts such as the World Health Organization, which are localized to urban centers. Private health care is unaffordable to most Somalians, leaving 5.5 million people in need of access to health care services. Those people living in rural areas often do not have the physical ability or desire to check for medical assistance or may die while trying to attain help. It is also notable that only 5% of Somalian children are fully immunized due to lack of education and limited access. The third component of the model is health status, which speaks to the prevalence of disease and morbidity. When the relative risk factors are actualized, health status declines. The vast incidence of drought in the country has led to the largest outbreak of cholera in the last 5 years. In 2017, 78,000 people were affected by cholera and acute watery diarrhea. Due to drought and food insecurity, more than 360,000 children are acutely malnourished, along with the additional 3 million people who go hungry every day. Of these, 250,000 people died from hunger in 2011. Overcrowding in urban centers and poor vaccination statuses has led to an immense outbreak of measles. 71% of children under the age of 5 have been affected. Somalia has the second highest infant mortality rate in the world, at 94.8 deaths per 1,000 live births.
From the EMIC perspective, as a humanitarian aid worker working in Mogadishu, the extremely dangerous and war-torn capital of Somalia, our eyes have witnessed horrific sights. Thousands of people have been forced out of their homes and towns by Al-Shabaab. There's no food, no safe drinking water, or health care. Children are dying right in front of our eyes from preventable diseases. I recently talked to a mother who carried her son who was suffering from severe dehydration several miles to the nearest hospital. She did not make it in time and held her child in her arms as he died.
In the war between South Vietnam and North Vietnam, in which the United States and the Soviet Union played a major role, the Hmong people suffered. The United States recruited and trained the Hmong people to fight against Southern Vietnam. Unfortunately, the Hmong people were rapidly losing to the Vietnamese military, forcing the United States to retreat. Once they left the country, the genocide of the Hmong people began. Initially, Thailand was a safe refuge for them, but not for long. Once the Thais started kicking them out, they were left nationless and homeless, constantly moving around in fear of being killed or dying. The Hmong people can be compared to the Somalis in the sense that the Somalis have been facing internal displacement in their country due to the powerful militant forces of Al-Shabaab. Some Somalis have been able to escape to neighboring countries, but many are like refugees in their own country. Although the health conditions in Laos are not as grave as in Somalia, living in a war-torn country negatively affects civilian health. According to the 2018 Humanitarian Needs Overview, Somalia is still in dire need of food and nutrition in both rural and urban areas. It is predicted that the droughts will continue into 2018. Therefore, humanitarian aid is crucial to supporting the people of Somalia until environmental and security conditions improve. One initiative that could be supported for the Somalis would be to introduce the Toilet Board Coalition. This organization's goal is to increase access to sanitation in areas of low income and develop partnerships with the people in that area. If this program was to be implemented in Somalia, it could empower the people to help increase their sanitation, thereby decreasing the rates of cholera and acute watery diarrhea. Although the challenges Somalia faces may seem insurmountable, one small change is where it begins.